the next topic, which is the searching technique. So there are many searching techniques. We'll see about the linear search and the binary search. Linear search is what? Means sequential search. Each element is compared, the list element, all the elements are compared from the beginning to the end, till the time the element is reached or searched, right? It either reaches the end or find the value. So this is called the linear search. And we'll see an algorithm which will search an element called ELEM from the list, which is called as data list. This containing the size number of the elements. Okay. So let us go ahead. This algorithm says that we have a list. We start with the counter 0 and this is the size. This upper bound U is the size of the list. Then we have to repeat these steps, means you have to either apply the while or the for loop until you reach the end. So if you, for every counter, means from this 0, 1, this indices, every counter you have to search for the element, means this data list 0, let me write D for data list, D0, D1, you have to compare it. If it is found, you will just print element found at this location, CTR plus 1, and you will break this loop. And you will do it again and again. These two are in one loop, so you have to go again till the time this is done. Because once it is done, you are eventually coming out of the loop. If this doesn't happen for all the elements, and if you reach the end, then you say that we were not able to find out the value or search the value. And then you end, right? This is what we do here. This is the Python program for searching an element from the list. We call it as data list. So this def is a function for linear search. And here we have the list and the element we need to search. We start with flag equal to 0 and we use a for loop for CTR, which will take the values or counter in data list, and all these elements one by one will be checked with the element needs to be searched. And we say element found at this location, flag becomes 1. So if flags remain 0, we say element not found. Flag is 1, we come out. So linear searching is simple, but it has some caveats or drawbacks. If the element, say you have 1 lakh element or 1000 or maybe more, if this element is say at the last, or it is found near the end, then the searching will be time consuming, because this search in sequential manner, one by one. How to overcome this drawback? Then the best thing is to find another search, which is the binary search. So binary search does what? Binary search, this is the searching technique where we do one thing is very important here, that these members should be in ascending or descending order. So if it is ascending and descending order, then only you can go on with binary search. First condition is this. So what will happen here is, because these are in ascending and descending order, we know that the lowest one is here, highest one is here. Then we search, we start with this element. We start with the middle element. That is the mid one of this. We'll compare our element, say x, with the middle element, say m is the middle element. We start with search here. Two things can happen, or rather three things can happen. M may be equal to x, means in the first go you find this middle element to be the value which is to be searched. The second thing which can happen is this value is less than this value. So now you don't need to search here because these all values are greater than m. So you will start with this beginning and you will end up with 1 minus of this m, right? Because m or you have already searched. So 0 to m minus 1 you will search. And the third condition is this x happens to be more than this m. Then what you will do? You will search here only, because you will not find it here. All these values are less than m. So now you will take this m plus 1 because m already is being checked, and this last, say l is the last value or size value. So m plus 1 and l, Now your initial will be this and last will be this. And you will do it iteratively. Means again, for this m plus 1 and l, you will find the central value. You will again check x with this. Three things can happen. Either x becomes this or x is found here. Or x may be less than. So you search this arena. Or x is greater. So you search in this region. Again, you will do the same thing. So this goes recursively. So every time you search, the things or the elements becomes half. So every time if you search, the complexity will be only order of log base to 2n. So this is the searching technique which will reduce the number of comparison and saves your processing time. Okay, ascending and descending is the must condition. So if you want to search for an element, the list is sorted. Element is first compared with the middle element. If the element is greater than the middle element, the latter part, this part is searched. If the latter parts, now the latter parts becomes the only new subarray which needs to be searched. Okay. If the element is smaller than the middle element, then this is the only part, the former part. This is the segment you are going to search. So this goes on again and again. And the number of comparison, they are reduced proportionately. And this is very log n is very less than n. Means this is hugely less than n. If you compare n items, you just have to compare log n base to 2 items. So the time is very less. So just assume that you have an element you need to search. So element will be compared with the middle element. Then you, if it is found, then it is okay. Otherwise you go to left or right depending upon whether it is greater than the middle one or higher than the middle one. So this again and again goes on. So let us see how we actually work on it. This is the algorithm. The algorithm is like this. We have a low and then a high upper bound. And these are going to change. If the element is not found, these will change. How? Let me show you. I'll write L for low, high for H. Right? Just assume that L is for low, H for high. We start with low equal to 0 and high equal to size minus 1. Means from 0 to this size minus M, say N elements are there. We start with 0 and N. And we find out the midpoint. Midpoint has to be integer. We need to convert into integer 0 plus n by 2. So this is 0 plus n minus 1. Actually, it will be n minus 1 because we are starting from 0. So n minus 1, the element, you have to find the index actually. You are not dividing the actual element. You are just finding the initial and the last, the n value, not the element itself. So this is the indices. Low and high are the indices. So low plus high by 2. This is what you are going to do. Now you have got the middle one. This is 0 plus n minus 1 by 2. Now you search this element for this middle. Again, if you have to repeat step 3 to step 6, please understand you have to repeat this again and again. That is why I am telling low and high will change. If the element is found at the first go, you say element found and you will print the mid, that is the position where it is found, and you will break. Otherwise, as I said, three conditions may take place. First, you can find the element right here, or now the element is less than this mid element. So you have to search for say 7, and here you find 11. So you search 7 and 11, you compare. 11 is greater than 7, so you will not go here, you will go here. Let me take another condition, this one. If this is 7, this is 11. Then if you compare 11 with 7, you see that 11, you didn't find 11 here, but you know that this will be found here only because this is in ascending order. So you'll search in this position only. And for that, what you have to do? If you, first case let us take, if the element is greater than the mid, then this, if this is mid, let me name it as M, mid. So mid you have already checked. So now the low will be, because only this will be checked, the low will be mid plus 1. This is what is being done. Otherwise, if this comparison, you found that you have compared the value and this is less than. See, you, if this is 11 and you compared 7 with 11, then you see that 7 is not found, but you know that 7 is here. M already you have checked. So now the high will be m minus 1. So high will be m minus 1, mid minus 1. And this goes again and again. This is, it means recursive process. Again and again you are going to, not recursive, but iterative process. And if you do it again and again, and sometime low reaches, or low becomes greater than high, that means you have checked high has come here, low has come here. That means element is not found. This is how you compute the binary search. Okay. The Python program for the same will be, you will make a binary search program. This is the list. This is the complete list. This is the element. This is low and high. And low is 0 at first go. High will be the length of data list. As we said, the n minus 1, the whole complete number of elements, because we are starting from 0 indices, then we have to take n minus 1. But here you can directly take the length. This will give you the value. Okay. Now low is less, while low is less than high, that means if always low will be less than high. But if at all it doesn't happen, then you just have to say, sorry, element not found. But if low remains less than high, then first you have to add this low and high, means the indices, not the element, but the indices. Low plus high by 2. So this is your first mid. You will check the element for the mid. If it is found, you say print mid and break. Otherwise, this is the first condition, that you found it in the middle. If you didn't find, then you see that element is greater than mid, then you have to set the low to mid plus 1. Means this will be mid plus 1 and this will remain like this, low. And if the element happens to be less than this, then now this has to be changed. High has to be changed. High will become mid minus 1, because mid you already checked. So from this value to this, or this region will be checked. And this goes on again and again, and the value will be found either, or you will say element not found.